I just need a reason. I just need to know what's on your mind. Tell me what you're needing. You can call my name, I'll be around. Dum da da, dum dum da da, dum da da, dum dum da da, dum dum. The sky is falling. Dum dum da da, dum dum da da, dum da da, dum dum da da. That will keep you safe and sound.
Xavier Snow from Snow's Globe checking in. Look, man, I just wanted to show you guys a different perspective, kind of what my day looked like before I kind of started the bar crawl. Give you a glimpse of the Airbnb, the pool. We had nice views. Unfortunately, no rooftop, but hey. So I made sure this time that before I started the bar crawl that I actually got some food. And unlike Medellin, I made sure that I ate, had a full stomach, everything was good. So unfortunately, what that meant was I was a little late for the bar crawl, but hey, at least I had some food. So I went to this Japanese restaurant next door and I had these like salmon rice cakes, which was like delicious, man. I can't even hold you. Then I had some chicken and rice, which took a little longer than I expected, and that kind of made me more late. And then the chicken wasn't even hitting like that. So, yeah, kind of blown, but the salmon cakes was on point. After that, I went next door to the bar. It's called Rabbit Hole, and it just really had some real, like, classy vibes. I made it in time for a group shot. As you can see, we were a diverse bunch, but you know, hey, it was good, man. I had a great time. Then we headed to the second bar of the night and was just kind of able to chop it up.
All right, so we just left bar number one. I don't even know what the name of it is, but I had a drink and it was a low-key sleeper sneaker because I am feeling that one drink right now. But we're headed to a second bar of the night. I met some folks from the DMV. Say what's up, DMV folks.
Hi.
That was so weak. You're making us look
what's
bad.
Up?
What's
up? I just need to know what's on your mind. Tell me what you need.
So we headed to the second bar. Like I said, this bar had a really cool arcade type of vibe. I really enjoyed this bar just because they had things I've never seen in a bar, which is like real cool games. You know, they had gaming stations for adults, and I think that's important that we play. So after that, we vibed out a little bit more at Atomic and we played some beer pong. It was a really good chemistry bonding experience. It's just really good place. If you want to come here, I definitely recommend you come with the group. Cause it was just vibes. It's a really good place to just have fun and, you know, hang out with your friends.
Lock have faith.
It's still kind of early, so we're good.
Drink some Thai shots, and then if anyone want to stop and smoke, we can do that. And then we're gonna go to two more clubs.
Cop on cop.
Solid.
For that, what? What a song request.
You can type. But don't play it yet. I'll put it in a queue.
How you feeling, bro?
The first one's gonna be alright. Yeah.
You feel alright?
Waiting for the 2 hour spot, and that's where we're going.
Yeah!
That's it.
Don't tell her baby, no way. But she got me on the counter. Wasn't me. Saw me hanging on the sofa. Wasn't me. I even had her in the shower. It wasn't me. She even got me on camera. It wasn't me.
Hey! Okay, so next thing I know, I ended up taking 6 shots back to back. I went to the bathroom, I came back, and apparently everybody had taken 4 shots in that 3 minutes. So I somehow had to take 6 shots. But luckily, you know, I am a boss, and I did what I had to do. Medellin, Medellin. Ooh. Salud, salud.
Talking about some Medellin, man. We in Bangkok. The next night, I went out with my homie Slim from college. This man's been living in Bangkok since January and has been traveling since August. Kind of like me, but he really hasn't been home. Shout out to him, for real. You're like, if you have remote work, man, anything is possible, honestly. But yeah, this bar was a complete vibe. It was real, real classy, you know, just nice ambiance. The waitresses were dope, especially Shorty right here. I wish I knew her name. She was a complete vibe the whole time. Even recorded us and everything.
I can't mess with y'all. I could tell they ain't real. I can't get involved. Ooh, I seen them now when they tryna call. Ooh, the summer's mine, but they tryna watch me fall. Yeah, I'm shining bright, got me feeling like I'm next. Like I'm feeling like I'm crazy.
So unfortunately, my boy got a little too faded and had to call it a night earlier than expected after the first bar. So hey, man, I get it. I've been there, man. So I decided to head to this Lusty Lady bar because they had the ladies out there, man, recruiting, and they caught me. So I'm like, man, why not? You know, these drinks are cheap as hell. I could afford a drink or two. So I was out there vibing, played Connect Four with Shorty. I said, look, man, if I win, you got to give me a kiss. She was with it. She still lost, though. So the way these things work is you basically buy the girls a drink and, you know, talk to them. And eventually, you know, if you want to have a good time or take them to your hotel or whatever, hey, you can do that too. It's not really as taboo as it sounds. So after whooping her a few times in Connect Four, she's like, yeah, let's just play some pool. Can we play pool? And I'm like, yeah, okay, we can do some pool. We play some pool. And one thing I will say about Thailand, that compared to DR and Colombia, the rate of English, especially among like the women and young women, is way higher. So it's a lot easier to date and communicate when you have that language bond. On this game, I said, look, if I win, you gotta come home with me tonight. So, you know how to take care of business. She wanted me to come back around 2 when she got off, but I went to another club and got a little distracted, as you'll see. The next club is called Sugar Club. It was a really dope club. They focus on hip hop, Afro beats, and each level is a different club. So first level is old school, the second level is Afro beats, and the third level, which is Sugar Club, is all hip hop. How it works is you pay about 400 baht, which comes to around $7. And you can get in and you get a drink. So you go to the club, meet people, vibe out, and you get a free drink with entry. So I also went to Bafros, which is the name of the club right below it. And like I said, they play mostly Afro beats, but again, a diverse crowd. Very diverse crowd. People vibing. All ages, colors. Good vibes, man. Good vibes. Everybody was showing me love, which I really appreciated. She is the reason why I got a little distracted and didn't make it back to the Lusty Lady Bar, but hey, we had fun. Another club that I would say is possibly an honorable mention is Panacea. This is a new bar that just opened up in Bangkok, and it's really dope. Like, the inside is dope, the decor is dope, people were vibing. And one thing I like about this place is every night there's a different performing act. So first night we went, there was these ladies over here dancing, Michael Jackson, Bruno Mars. They did a great job. But there's like always different types of performance. Like one day I went there, it was a magician. It's crazy. And then this guy or girl, I'm not sure. But there's another bar not far from this place. It's called Pastel, and it's a beautiful rooftop bar, and it's very hip vibes, very cool energy, all love. It is a little bit more on the pricier side, but pricey for Thailand is really just average anywhere in the United States. So yeah, great vibes, great times, good energy, good people. I love the saxophonist and the drummer. Like, I've never seen that in a bar. So that was a vibe. All in all, I would give Bangkok a nightlife rating of 8.5, just because there's so many different things to do. Can't really get bored out here, so I'm very grateful that I was able to stay in Thailand for about 64 days this year.
And I highly recommend that you guys come out and check it out for yourself. Don't just read and believe what you see or hear on social media. You actually have to experience for yourself and see what it's like. All right, y'all. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Xavier Snow, and you're watching Snow's Globe. Peace.